Okay, hey there everybody, welcome to swiftdynamics.com and our first webinar in a series for small businesses. So let's go ahead and get started. First of all, thank you for joining us. All of our webinars are available on our YouTube channel through our parent company, WebSend Solutions, Inc. And also for our Dynamics NAV solution for small businesses, Swift Dynamics. So you can get there through either way. We do have, as many of you know, if you've attended webinars before, with us, we have WebSend University, which is all of our online training courses. I think there's north of 50 or so of those and over 800 students, so that's just great. And on when it comes to Navision, which is the product we'll be reviewing today, that's on a Swift Dynamics website. We've already got 19 different training videos out there, so I encourage all of you to take a look at those. As well, it covers a lot of what we're going to talk about today and even more, and we're adding at least 2 to 3 a week. So some really good stuff there for your small business and to learn more about the solution. So let's talk about what we've got. WebSend traditionally is a Dynamics GP and CRM partner, as well as Office 365, and now we're adding through swiftdynamics.com an affordable solution that's really Dynamics NAV for small business, if you're familiar with Navision. So it's very affordable. A light user license starts at just $49 a month, so very different than the Dynamics GP solution. It's very, very simple to use, 100% cloud-based on Microsoft's infrastructure and accessible anywhere in the world 24/7. A couple unique things here. It's fully integrated to Dynamics CRM and Office 365 as well, and we'll kind of get at that a little bit today. But as far as how you access it, it's got a mobile version, a tablet version, a web version, as well as a fully installable Windows client as well. So very flexible with respect to how you access the system. And we'll talk about some interesting nuances with that as well as we go through today. So really what I want to do today is walk you through what I'll call are fairly simple scenarios for small businesses. So first is really taking an order, processing it through, invoicing it, and applying a cash receipt to it, collecting money, which is 95% probably of what small businesses do on the AR side of things. And we'll get into in future webinars even more detail. We'll also talk a little bit today about integration to CRM when it comes to sales order processing and things like that. Then procure to pay, and again, when you look at what a small business needs out there in the world, it's purchase orders, the ability to process POs and receive both inventory and non-inventory POs, process an invoice from a vendor, and then pay a vendor. So we'll cover that as well in all its different flavors. And then finally, we'll wrap it up with financial reporting and business intelligence. I think you'll be quite pleased at where or what capabilities this fairly inexpensive solution brings to the table. And I get asked the question a lot, how does this compare to QuickBooks as an example? Because a lot of small businesses have QuickBooks Online, FreshBooks, things like that. I think what you'll find is really a couple of things. One, it's full integration to Dynamics CRM, which a lot of small businesses have, as well as Office 365, which again, a lot of our clients have, is pretty much unprecedented. So Microsoft has done an excellent job in integrating both this ERP solution as well as O365 and CRM. I think the other thing you'll notice as well is really when it comes to reporting and business intelligence, it's quite a robust solution. And we'll give you a couple samples from reporting, but we'll spend a little bit more time on the business intelligence side, which again, just comes right out of the box and offers 365 and doesn't even cost anything else. But it's really, really a nice, robust solution for reporting. So let's jump in here real quick. What I'm going to do is we're going to jump into the web version of Navision. And first I'm going to start just kind of giving you a tour of the system per se. So as I mentioned, this is the web version. There is a full-blown Windows client as well as a tablet, and you can also access it on your mobile. But let's just start with a quick little tour of the system. So really over here on the left side, I've got my home screen and sort of my most frequently used transactions, some of which we'll be walking through today. I've also got the different menu areas that we've enabled for our small business solution. You can see up here the demo system I'm showing you today is small business for Swift Dynamics, and we've custom configured this role to really account for all of what a small business would need. Now, Navision is a far larger solution than even what we're showing today, and we'll probably get into that in future webinars. There's manufacturing, there's warehouse management, all the things that a small business would need maybe in the future, but may not need, you know, day one out of the box. So it's a system that can grow with you over time, which is obviously very important. And I think that's a huge differentiator when it comes to QuickBooks and FreshBooks and systems like that as well. Really what we've done is we've taken a very, very large ERP solution or accounting solution and really pared it down to what a small business needs. But that's not to say you can't add to it later on in the future quite readily, because it's just turning on and off different modules or different security settings. So keep that in mind when you take a look at this solution. A couple other things here. When we go to the home screen, we've got what's called these queues. So as an example, when I take a look at my home screen, I can tell, you know what, I've got $476,000 of sales here that are overdue. And by simply clicking on it, I can get into and see exactly what these different invoices are that are late, and drill in as well into those exact documents, etc. Okay? So again, the ability to drill down, see at a, off a cuff kind of what's late, what's my overdue purchase invoices that I should be paying, what's my total sales this month. Now those can also be configured. So if I go in here to set up those queues, I can turn on and off various queues. I can set what these limits are and when they get into red or yellow or frankly no color at all. So again, completely configurable here on the screen. Down here I've got my list of favorite customers. I've also got reports that maybe I want to receive in my inbox on a weekly basis, i.e. maybe it's an open AR report, maybe it's a little pro forma P&L, things like that. But you'll see later on we can create reports and schedule reports to be delivered automatically. As we continue our little tour of the home screen here, you'll see I've got different KPIs. So cash flow view by year, I can go to the next chart and keep looking at income expense. Now I can change these views to by month, I can change them by day, by week. And these are all based really on the back end SQL reporting services and also obviously how we configure the system. So some really nice functionality here. I can drill down to things, filter things, etc. So some really nice functionality here as far as KPIs and such go. And you'll see right then I clicked on that little bar chart that took me to the Canon Group PLC, which is the detail view of a particular customer. While we're here, let's just spend a little bit of time taking a look at this. So number one, I've got my total sales. Obviously, I've got an address, a little Bing map. You know, God bless Microsoft. It's a little Bing map that just shows us where this customer is located. I've got my various invoicing, credit limits, things like that. I've got basically some information on payment terms, other things like that. And then finally down here, I've got my statistics. So here, quickly at a glance, I can see what's overdue for this particular customer, and I can drill down into that if I want. You'll see a little report comes up that shows me just all the overdue payments. I can go into what's been posted this year, what they've paid us this year, my age they are, and how old it is, etc. Any credit memos, discounts, and down here you'll see there's special pricing as well. Okay, and I can even show more statistics if I really want. Oops, keeps flipping around on me there. There we go. I can show more information or less information as I want. Now, a couple things to note of interest over here. I talked about this in my opening statement, but this integration with Dynamics CRM as well, you'll see here, I can see that there are 13 open opportunities and 5 open cases. I can actually go and drill into what these are and actually navigate to that particular record in CRM. So if we go to one maybe that's in progress, it'll actually launch CRM. We'll actually be able to see that record right there. So this just takes a second, so we'll give that a second here. But one other thing to note is that I don't need to separately log in to CRM either. It actually did it for me. It's taking me right to that record, and this kind of gets to my previous comments as well about that integration between CRM and Office 365 as well as Navision. So here's this particular opportunity that was listed there in Navision next to the customer record, okay? And again, it's automatically logged to be in. You can see here, my name for this demo is Spencer Lowe. If I click in to here, way over here on the corner, you can see that Spencer L, that's my name, in Dynamics NAV. So really seamless integration back to Dynamics CRM. We'll touch on that a little bit more later, but we'll also probably hold a second webinar next month and get into the details about how this integration works. It's some pretty neat stuff. You can also see here on sales history, I've got posted sales invoices and things like that. So I can actually drill into any invoices that have been posted, and we'll see those in AR reports and things like that as well. So everything's kind of here at a glance with a customer record, and I got to that just simply by coming through one of these little charts on my home screen. Okay, here I've got sort of a mini P&L. So here's my revenue cost for this last month and this current month. You know, if I click into here, there's just a drill down on total income statement, and I can actually get down to the particular detail line on what was posted on that particular GL account. So again, throughout the system, I've got the ability to really drill down from anywhere. I've got this home screen. I've got my list of customers. So some really nice functionality here as far as what we're able to get to and what we're able to tackle. Now, there's also, even if you can't, maybe you don't want to navigate, maybe you just want to search, as an example, I can get to my customer list right from just a little search window up here on the corner, and that then takes me to my list of customers. And even then, I can search here, and it'll bring up the Canon group, and it's a full text search. So just me being able to search and find things very, very quickly is a huge advantage when it comes to navigating within Dynamics Dynamics Navision. So that being said, as we sort of get to the point where we're going to start selling some stuff, let me also take a look at the item that we're going to go sell. So I'm going to go over here to the inventory module, and you see there's a long list of items here. So I'm going to go search for the one that we want, which is this little guy. And when I click on it, it takes me to the item master. And just like the customer, I kind of want to just take you on a quick tour here of what that means. But you can see here's the item and its description. Here's how much I've got in inventory. We'll kind of come back to that a little bit later. But as I alluded to, this system's a lot bigger than what you might find in its equivalent price point in like a QuickBooks or a FreshBooks. I've got all this different costing method, different tax calculations. Down here at the bottom, I've got different replenishment methods. Who I buy it from, is it a make or is it a buy? You'll notice this particular one is a purchase, but I've got some manufacturing type constraints as well. I've got planning, so do I want to reorder this product? How do I reorder this product? What are its minimums and maximums? So that way I can actually use, even as a small business, kind of a light MRP, if you will, and then the system will tell me what I need to buy and what I need to order. Okay, got some pretty deep functionality as well for international trade. We're not going to get into it today, but there's a full multi-currency capability. The system actually connects to Yahoo for its daily exchange rates, and that's also included in the license fees. Okay, I can track items by serial numbers or lot numbers as well, and I can also manage where it sits in the warehouse, how to put it away, how to pick it, and things like that. So these are all kind of features and functions that we've made available to small businesses. Now, some, quite frankly, may use them. Some may not. But what it allows us to do is kind of start simply or start easier or at a scaled down model with our clients. And then it allows us room to grow, which allows us also to implement the system at a relatively reasonable, very small price point. You know, some projects we've done have been darn near close to free. So it's a very, very simple system to implement as well. And there's even a YouTube video that we've got already out there that shows you how to import basically all of your master data, your items, your customers, and all that fun stuff to get you up and running. So that's really what we do with our clients is basically give them templates that they just fill out and we upload it all and it configures the system right from scratch. So a lot of stuff that's really capable right out of the box. Now, if we take a look at this item, you can see off to the right side, I've got some details here about how that item is configured, what the costs are, etc. And if we take a look at item availability by location, as I've selected that item, now it shows my inventory in all these different locations. So you can actually see I've got 44 on hand here in the blue warehouse. That's the warehouse we're going to sell our inventory out of. I've got 88, 83 in the green and 43 in the yellow. If I drill down on that, you can actually see the transactions that took place to affect that 43. And you can actually see here, we had an opening adjustment of 41, and then I bought 10 more. So that's what led to that increase in inventory. Okay? So some pretty simple functionality there, but again, really, really valuable as far as what small businesses can take advantage of. There's also non-stock items. You can have multiple warehouses. You can have obviously multiple locations and different units of measure. That's what a stock keeping unit is. Okay, and you can see here, I mean, even if you're doing e-commerce, you can put a picture in. You've got UPC identifiers, a lot of different stuff that really you wouldn't find in sort of an application at this particular level that we're working on, but a lot of capability out there in this system as well. Okay, so that being said, I'm gonna go back to the home screen and we're gonna go sell this little guy to a customer of ours. So I'm gonna go in here to my sales order list. Now earlier I mentioned the fact that this connects seamlessly to Dynamics CRM, and one thing I wanna show you as well is you'll see here there's a button linked to Dynamics CRM to pull down sales orders. And what this is meant to do, I don't have any out there at the moment, obviously, but what this is meant to do is if I put sales orders in to Dynamics CRM, so I've got salespeople out there doing quotes and doing orders, there's no rekeying that needs to be done. So I can simply go and process that order within Dynamics CRM, which, like I said, we'll do a webinar maybe next month on that subject. But from a finance perspective, once that order is processed, I simply come here and pull that list down into Navision, process it into an invoice, and we're good to go. Now I can generate PIC documents and stuff like that, but we'll talk about that here in a minute. But really, that's a huge advantage in that there is no double keying of information. I don't have to worry about mistakes and paperwork and emails and stuff like that. You can even do workflows from CRM to notify the finance group when an order has been submitted so they know they need to go pull it down. So a lot of really great functionality between the two systems. And like I said, we'll cover that kind of in the next webinar series. But right now what we're going to do is we're going to put in a new sales order. So we just received a sales order from our favorite customer, which is the Canon Group. Now, one of the things it's saying here is, you know what, that customer's overdue. Do you want to just continue forward? And we'll go, yeah, don't worry about it. We'll keep going with that particular customer. But just to show you that we can do credit holds and things like that as well. Now, the one thing I'm going to quickly do is we're going to ship this out of the blue warehouse. So you can see that's actually been changed here. I'm just going to double check that everything else is kosher. We'll see. Yep, that all looks good. And then I'm going to go ahead and add my item to this order. So one of the things you're going to notice right off the bat, and again, this is important, I think, for small businesses. Number one, I can sell inventory. But the other thing I can do is I can sell what's called a non-inventory item, or in Navision parlance, it's called a resource. So what that means is if I'm simply selling professional services like consulting and things like that, that's obviously not inventory. But I'm actually going to sell that resource. So I'm just going to sell, say, consulting services, say 10 hours at $100 is $1,000 of consulting services. And the system allows me to simply do that as well. So for this example, we're going to go ahead and sell that 1988-S item, which is that sole guest chair. We're going to sell it out of the blue warehouse, and I'm going to sell 10 of those guys. Okay? You'll see the system's figuring out the tax and everything automatically. That we've configured in the back end. And again, we'll probably cover that off in a later webinar. Now, quite simply, all I need to do right now is close this out. And you can see this is sales order 1007. I'm just going to hit close here. And then what you'll see is 1007 is now showing up down here on my list. So the system's automatically saved it for me. I don't really need to do anything else for that matter. And now what I can do is I can go up here to actions and I can go ahead and release that order. And you can see there's a status there. So what you can do with that is you can create a workflow that notifies the guys in the warehouse that they can go pick it. You can restrict their security so they can actually go and take a look at creating a PIC document. Okay, and there's a lot of different things that can be done in this system. So again, you can create a shipment for it. You can print out all your PIC documents and things like that, and you can see kind of a lot of that stuff over here. Now, also bear in mind, one of the key functionalities that anybody looks for, quite frankly, is the ability to email. So I can post this and ship these goods out, but I can also email that invoice to that customer automatically as long as my email is tied to it. And this gets back to my previous mention a couple times now of Office 365. So you'll see actually here, I can go back and get to Office 365 right from Dynamics NAV. Here are all the different apps that I've got. Now, I don't want to demo NAV to you today. Or sorry, don't want to demo Office 365, but just to show you quickly, I can get there. And even when I come back into NAV, guess what? I'm actually sitting right here back in the place that I left off. And you've actually got that same functionality over here in CRM. I'm looking at the same account over here in CRM. I've got a button that can take me into that account record in Dynamics NAV. And even over here on the right side, I've got different account statistics for that particular customer. And you can see it was updated a couple of hours ago because I actually had put through some payments and some orders in preparation for this webinar. So even in CRM, right out of the box, I've got information on the outstanding balance, what sales orders are there, any service orders are there, what the credit limit is, what's overdue, et cetera, et cetera. So right out of the box, we've got this great integration with Dynamics CRM in NAV as well. So now that I've created this sales order, we're going to go ahead and post this little guy and ship these goods out, okay? So I'm going to hit post and print. Now, again, I can split this out and ship it separately, then I can invoice it separately, or I can simply ship it and invoice it. So today, I'm just going to go ahead and ship and invoice this guy. Okay, so that's been done, and now what I'm going to do is, if I take a look at posted sales invoices here, you can actually see over here on the side, I've got all the different types of documents. But if I take a look at posted sales invoices for the Canon Group, and I can filter on, as an example, Canon, okay? Here's that little guy that I think I just posted, 13034. We'll take a look at this, okay? There's those 10 chairs that we just did, okay? And there's the total value. So very quickly, I can go see that posted invoice out there. I can filter lists, and this feature is available anywhere in the system, but very quickly, I can take a look at what those invoices are that are outstanding. Now, if I go back to this customer, again, let's just go find the Canon Group here, okay? What you're going to see is when I go down to the statistics, okay, I've actually, our amount of posted sales invoices has actually increased. If you vaguely recall from before, that list was 5, now it's 6. Okay, and even if I go in to CRM and refresh this, I think this might be on a 5-minute timer, but CRM will actually eventually refresh with that new open balance. So we'll see if it did that already. And we'll be able to tile that from the timestamp. So actually it did. You can actually see the time just changed to 11:22, which was the time that I just posted that invoice, and that's what then affected that total balance for that particular customer. So immediately I'm sharing information between all these different pieces and parts of Office 365, okay? And again, when I take a look at this customer, I can drill in here to these posted invoices, sorry, and it will come up with that same list, and here's that same invoice that we just saw, okay? Now again, these are indicating not sent because I didn't email it, because I didn't actually hook up the email functionality yet, but again, that's able just simply to be emailed from Office 365 directly, okay? Last but not least, a really, really easy way to accept payments from customers. So let's say, as a simple example, we get a check today from a customer, and right from my home screen here, I can go to a really simple function called payment registration. And then, again, let's say this particular payment was received from John Haddock Insurance Company. What you see in front of you is the list of all the different invoices that are outstanding. Okay, and you can actually see here's that last one. that we just posted. Now, obviously, the client isn't probably going to pay that one right away. But real quick, I get a check-in from somebody. For this example, I'm going to assume it's John Haddock, so I'm going to apply a filter to just say Haddock because I want to see all its opening entries. And you know what? Here's the one they paid. And all I have to do is simply hit this little checkbox, and that's it. And then what I'm going to do is just post that payment. And that's it. I'm done. So I can actually do a full-blown cash receipt as well, but I don't even have to. I can just come in here and say, yep, we received the cash from that particular customer. And then when I go into that particular customer in John Haddock, I can go down to the statistics information. I can take a look at payments received this year. And you'll see there's that little payment that we just processed today. Okay, and forgive me, but I forgot to mention in the beginning, but this is my system demo date of February 16th, 2018. Okay, so very, very simple even to receive a payment. So quickly, let's just go back and review kind of what we talked about so far. So we looked a little bit at sales order processing. I quickly just put through an item. Invoicing, we took a look at really how quickly we can invoice somebody and how quickly we can apply cash. So all things from a small business perspective that are obviously very important that really would occupy, quite frankly, most of our days in our small business world. We're basically selling stuff and invoicing people. So again, that's kind of the most important thing that we do. So next piece is procure to pay. So let's jump in here and take a look at purchasing. So, you know, the second most popular thing, I think most of us like to collect money rather than spend money. But let's take a look at our item again. So I'm going to go home. I'm going to go take a look at this item, and we're actually going to go buy that 1988S. So again, I'm going to search for it, and here it comes up on my list. Okay. Again, we're going to go take a look at item inventory by location. There's that blue warehouse. Okay. And again, we're going to go click on that balance. Oops. Reason my little report didn't come up properly, so give me 2 seconds. Let me just refresh it. There we go. So let's take a look at that quantity on hand, and now you can see there's that purchase receipt again and that positive adjustment. So that's how we got to our total, and then the sales have netted out from there appropriately. Okay? Now what we're going to do is we're actually going to go buy this little guy. So I'm going to go back to my home screen here, and we're going to now go to purchase orders. But right before we do that, we're going to go take a look at the vendor that we're going to use. So the vendor that we're going to use is this AR Day Property Management. And just a quick tour of the vendor record, very similar to a customer record, really. At the end of the day, I've got some simple statistics. I've got payment terms and an address and email for confirmation. And just like the customer record, I can drill into the history of that vendor and take a look at all of the different invoices and payments that we've sent out to that particular customer, or sorry, to that particular vendor, okay? I can drill into each of those entries as well and take a look at obviously the GL posting that took place in addition to any of the subledger entries, okay? So this is actually the subledger entry that was posted back in the beginning when the system was created. So the ability to drill down from one level to the other, obviously that's critical in all of our businesses. And then again, over here on the right side, I've got a quick reference to basically what are the different open posted purchase invoices that are out there. And these are the three that are sitting there. Okay? So that's, again, very simple vendor information. So what we're actually going to do is we're going to go over here to purchase orders. And we're going to go create a new one. So we're going to go buy some of this stuff. In a later webinar, I think we'll come back to kind of what I mentioned about automatic ordering and things like that. But again, just taking it quickly on a tour of the PO, I've got a purchase order I'm placing with this particular vendor. So here's all the information that came over from the customer card or from the vendor card. Now you'll notice what I'm going to do here is I'm actually going to change the location we're buying this into blue rather than yellow because I want to buy it into the blue location. Okay. I've got foreign trade info down here if it were multi-currency. I've got prepayment, which I could do if I needed to. Okay, and then I've got electronic invoicing if I'm accepting electronic invoice for payment for this. But what I'm going to do is, again, I can buy an inventoried item, which is this little guy, or I can buy something that is not an inventoried item. So again, we've got the ability to do both. I can cut a PO to just a particular general ledger account if I want, and just use text description as well. So we're going to buy this 1988-S, and you'll see this also does type ahead. So quite frankly, if I just start typing, it's going to pick the item for me, and I can pick, I can skip out on GST, but we're going to buy 10 more of these little guys, okay? And as I scroll over to the right, you'll see the default location is set to blue somewhere up in here. I don't know where, there it is. There's location set to blue, which followed the header. And as soon as I tab off the field, you'll see, you'll see that there's my total to be purchased. Now, as soon as I save this, this is purchase order 106027, you'll see it down here at the bottom, okay? So this is just an open PO right now. Haven't really done anything with it. When we go to this, again, same thing as I had mentioned earlier, I can print this and post it. I can also email it to the particular vendor if I want. Let me just go home here and let's see. Where's my email? Sorry, I apologize. There we go. I can send, I can export this as electronic invoice. I can also then post this and it will automatically email it as well if the vendor has an email address. Okay. So right now, all I'm going to do is say, you know what? I'm going to put their invoice number in here. So we'll go 123456. And let's just all pretend that we're going to receive this into inventory. So a couple of things. One, I can simply receive it and then I can invoice it. I can process the invoice that I got from the vendor later. For this example, I'm simply going to receive and invoice this at the same time. So today we're kind of doing a brief overview of all these functions, but just to let you know what the system's capable of, really. Obviously, you can receive an invoice in two separate steps. Okay? So now that PO disappeared from my list, if we go back to this vendor, though, and click on him, okay? I click on my posted purchase invoices. Guess what? There's a brand new shiny invoice sitting out here for that amount that came from that PO, and here's those 10 guest shares out there, and there's that vendor invoice number that I processed. Okay? So that's now due for payment. Okay? Let's just real quick go back to our item inventory. Okay? And even for my home screen, by the way, if I just click on items, and we look at this item, so I can search for it, 1988, okay, you can see I've got 170 on hand there. So that's gone back to increase that inventory back up to its original level, okay? Just showing you a few different ways to get to stuff. So let's get a payment from this guy. So I'm going to go into cash receipt journals, okay, and I'm on the bank journal, so we're going to double-click into that. Okay, and now, quite frankly, we're going to go pay. Oops, sorry, I'm in cash receipts. Hold on one sec. That's not what I wanted to do. I apologize. Let's go back over into finance. There we go. Okay, so finance now. I want to go to payment journals. There we are. And I want to process a payment to a particular vendor. So we're going to go to our WWB operating account. So that's going to be over here. Okay, and when we go in, oops, this is actually a list of payment journals, so we don't need to do this, but what the system's actually showing here, let me do a multi-select real quick and see if I can delete all these guys so we can start from scratch. So just give me one second. Let's see if it will let me do this. Yes, indeed it will. Okay, so we're going to start from scratch here, and what I want to do, you kind of saw the end result there just because it's a demo system and I haven't, we had a lot of people playing in here, but really what I want to do is I want the system to tell me what I need to pay. Now, I can log right in here and I can say I want to charge, you know, pay a particular vendor $1,000, but that's not, I mean, that happens on occasion, but practically speaking, what I really want the system to do is tell me who the heck I need to pay and when. So we're just going to come right to the screen. I'm going to go right up here to suggest vendor payments. A little screen's going to pop up, and I'm going to say, you know what, find me everything from 2018 We're going to post this, where's my new posting date, as of January 26, 2018, so a few days ago. Now, a couple things to note here. Number one, let's say, as an example, I've only got, say, $20,000 to spend on vendor payments this week. I can actually restrict the system and then tell it to really pay my vendors by priority. So in my vendor record, I can assign a priority to vendors. I could do it that way, or I could do it by due date, obviously. Okay. So if I use this available amount, you'll see I got a little error message there. I have to use vendor priority to do that. So we're gonna leave that on for the time being. Okay. And the only other thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna pay this from a bank account, and we're gonna pay it out of the WWB operating account. Okay, and we're going to do computer check. Now, a couple things to note here. We have the option of cutting a manual check if we want, like a one-time thing. We can cut computer checks, or we can also set up electronic payment. That's available both for the U.S. and Canada and Europe. So keep that in mind. We'll probably do a webinar on that as well. Okay, so I'm going to hit OK. Systems calculating, and because I put that limit up here, I actually came out with just a few payments that are due. And if I scroll over to the right, you can actually see the amounts here that add up to, looks like a little more than 20 grand, but that's really all I've got to work with for this particular day. Okay. Now from here on out, you can obviously see here, I can print a check, I can export payments. Now, one thing to note as well, the posting date that I put in there, these are all payments that were going to be posted on January 26th that were already due. You can actually see over here, the document date these were due is January 31st, so I am paying them a little bit early. But again, I could have filtered this list differently, and it would have caught things that were either overdue or I don't have to pay them if they're not yet due. Okay? So bear that in mind. I can change these posting dates as well so I don't pay people too early. But really, from here on out, all I need to do is really print those checks. Okay? If I click on one of the entries and go to apply entries, let's just go here and see. Oh, sorry, I actually have to apply the documents first, but let me go to one of these. Nope, that's not going to work either. Sorry, let me just finish documenting, filling these little fields out here. Yeah, you can actually see over here where it's been applied to from an invoice standpoint. So I'm actually applying this to invoice 108028, okay? That was actually due on the 31st of January. Now it's showing up that it's late because keep in mind my document date, my system date is currently in February of 2018. So that's why it's showing up late, and that's why it showed up on my list to pay today. Okay? Now I had backdated that posting date for January 26th, so that's why it shows up there. Okay? So as I drill into each of these, that's how each of these would be paid. And again, I would simply print the check from there. So that's really, at the end of the day, all that's really involved in paying vendors. It's very straightforward. I simply automatically generate that list, and then I'm off and running. Okay? So back to our presentation real quick. Again, PO processing receipts, invoice processing, and vendor payment. Now I simplified it quite greatly just because I simply did a PO. I processed it in one step to a receipt and invoice, and then I simply processed a payment list basically based on what was due. Okay, now let's get into reporting a little bit. Okay, so as I go back here, we're going to take a look at a couple things. One, I'm going to go over here to the finance module, and one of the things that's obviously important is a P&L. Now, to a small business, really what I care about is, quite frankly, what my revenue is and what my costs are for a particular month, and that I always have at a glance, and I can advance or move this back as need be to look at comparatives, okay? And you can see me just simply doing that. Now, I don't know if you noticed or not, but I've actually got this in sort of a graphical format as well. So here's my income and expense view by month. If I want to look at it by quarter, I can change it that way as well. So again, really, for my purposes as a small business owner, I really, really, really only care about sort of my profitability and revenue, right? So here I can quickly see what that looks like very, very quickly. Okay, and if we change this to month, by the way, let me just sort of take it back. Oops, sorry, I did the previous chart. I don't know if I can actually move. Yeah, I can move this previous period. Okay, what you'll notice is now this middle chart, okay, actually corresponds to this section here. So as I hover above these graphs, I've got 2.08392145, which is exactly the same amount down here. So really what the system's doing, it's using the same information. It's just one way is graphical, one way is kind of text-based, okay? So moving on, let's go over to the finance module now, and let's generate really what would be, what would one would call sort of a normal chart of accounts. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go up here to reports. You can see I've got sort of a bajillion of them available to me. I'm going to do income spread by period, and what we're going to set up here is basically I want to look at a income statement. So I'm going to change the filter there. I want to look at actual change. I want to look at monthly, and we're going to put a date filter of January 1st, 2018. Okay? And what I can do is, number one, when I send this, I can set this as a schedule. So I mentioned that before, that I can set up reports to show up my home screen, say every day, every week, something like that. A simple example might be an OpenAR report that I might schedule. I can actually export this as an Excel document if I want to manipulate it. Or in this example, I'm just going to quickly generate a PDF that we're going to take a look at. Okay? And this is just a quick, simple report for January of 2018 of my individual expenses and revenue. Okay? And there's my net income. So very straightforward little report. Again, I can put this in Excel. I can set up templates and make it look really, really fancy. Just a quick little sample there. You'll notice, too, when I look at the chart of accounts, I've got my net change in balance. These are balance sheet accounts. I can continue scrolling down and take a look at revenue, things like that as well. So here's my total revenue, 4,000 account for net change for February, which is basically nothing at this point. Okay? Let's go back home real quick because I want to show you some other kind of neat feature here. So earlier I showed you these queues, right? And I can drill in to this overdue sales amount and get a nice list here. But what I can also do is I can simply open this in Excel, and this is going to take a couple seconds, but it's automatically going to open up Office 365. It's automatically going to open up Excel online, and now I can actually play with this in Excel and manipulate it as I want. Okay? I can also, and one thing to notice is if I click over here on data, this is actually connected to my Navision database. So I can save this out here in O365 or even on my desktop, and it will save that database connection. So I can simply refresh my open receivables. I can create pivot tables. I can do a whole bunch of cool stuff. And also I can share it with people who are also members of my O365 group. I can edit it as well in my browser, create pivot tables, etc., all while keeping it refreshed and connected to that Navision Dynamics database. So pretty amazing functionality when you look at it, because really it's just fully integrated within O365. And again, you can see over here I'm in Excel online, and I can get to all my other features and functions in O365 as I see fit. One other big function really that comes with O365 is something called Power BI. And Power BI, this is actually connected to the Navision environment. And it's a graphical, this is just basically a dashboard, okay? But if we go in here and look at expenses and revenue by month, what you'll notice is I'm getting really nice KPIs and charts. And if I want to go back in history and look at various months, I can look at that November month that we were highlighting before, and there's my revenue, earnings, etc. Again, but now in a graphical format, okay? So I can drill in on that revenue filter, I can look at combinations of months, okay? Some really, really neat stuff here. I can look at item sales by customer, okay? And if I want to look at a particular item, I can do that as well. So let's take, say, 98.6-S. Let's see if there's any sales out there for that little guy. Or maybe I click on one and it'll automatically apply my filter for me. That's probably easier because I'm not exactly sure of which items I've sold and which I haven't, okay? But again, really easy to filter if I look at a particular customer and what Also by general posting group has been sold. Now I can get down to the details on particular items that have been sold to particular customers. Okay, we can go back to the main dashboard here as well. Okay, I can look at sales this month, which really is a number, but now I can look at it as a chart. I can filter by basically the types of products. Okay, I can filter by country. So say I want to look at, let's look at Iceland, that's got some data. Okay, what's my total revenue for Iceland? Who sold it? I can look at by sales rep. Okay, now if all this isn't good enough for me, one really, really neat feature is that I can actually just type away. So I want to say show as a map, say sales amount by country. And it literally, country. It literally generates that chart for sales by country. Okay, if I want to sales amount actual, here we go, by city, I can do that as well. And now if I want to zoom in, you can actually even see, oops, let me zoom out a little bit, different sales amount by different cities that are out there. Okay, if I want to look at it just in a list, I can say sales amount actual. You can see it's reconciling the database by customer for 2015. And then I should get, there's probably no data in 2015. Sorry, there we go, there's 2017. Okay, now even then, I can change this. If I want to do, say, a pie chart, it'll do as a pie chart. If I want to do it as a sort of a block chart, it'll do that way. I can do sidebar charts, I can do vertical ones. So a lot of capability here. Another one that's quite popular, actually, that a lot of customers ask for is show as a map sales amount, actual by, and now, I'm going to say for AH by country. Okay, so what I've done here is this is sales for a particular sales rep by country. Okay, now you can store these as permanent charts as well, so obviously you don't want to spend all your time typing away, but some really amazing capability when it comes to what you're able to drill down on. Okay, I've got item sales and profit, so what are my most profitable items by retail, by grouping, or by raw material? Okay. Just some really good reporting here. So this all comes, if you've got an Office 365 subscription, if you've got Dynamics Navision, it all comes right out of the boxes included. So there's actually all of these dashboards, et cetera, simply connect to the Dynamics NAV database. Now there's also, just to sort of expand on that, there's also a plugin for Dynamics CRM. So this is actually just quickly a dashboard, I believe, or a chart linked to Dynamics CRM for basically, this is just an example of smartphone sales. I think I've got another one here that is opportunities closed by sales rep, but this is coming from CRM, not from NAV. So you can actually combine information from multiple systems that you've got in Office 365 with Power BI at no additional cost. So that concludes this webinar. What I wanted to do today is really just kind of run through a high level of what we had available to small businesses, and I think you'll realize quite a bit of capability there when it really comes to integrating with O365, Power BI, and even Dynamics CRM. A lot of clients we have might even start with Dynamics CRM and then get into more of the accounting side of things with Dynamics NAV over time, but a really good capability there in how Microsoft has built all this infrastructure. So again, because of the way it's been set up and the way that we can simply give our clients a spreadsheet to fill in and then upload it into the system to configure it, really makes it quite an affordable solution for our clients as well. So we're very excited. I think next month, as I said, we're going to get into really that CRM integration because I think it's important to cover that. And then we'll go from there and probably get into more details. There are literally 19 different videos so far and growing almost daily for our clients. So if there's specific functions you want to see in the solution, please visit our YouTube channel and they will all be there. Okay? So that being said, thank you very much for joining us today. We're excited about the solution. Hopefully you are too. As usual with any of our webinars, please feel free to reach out. Thank you very much for your time again. Have an awesome day, and we'll send out information on what next month's webinar is going to be. Talk to you later.